guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you again for coming. And today I am doing a collab look with Stephanie Lita. I'll leave her link down below, but she did a look today with Exorcism of the Kat Von D liquid lip. And I did my look today with Bow and Arrow of Kat Von D liquid lip. If you've never tried Kat Von D's product, you are living under a rock. They are the most wonderful formula, these liquid lips. Yes, they are a matte finish, but they do not leave your lips dry or making you feel like they're just gonna crack throughout the day. Great formula, and I love the Kat Von D product so far. So if you guys wanna go ahead and check out Stephanie Lita's channel to try to get inspired by a dark lipstick, which is Exorcism, go ahead and check out her channel and she will show you how you can achieve a look using that color. And here I am showing you how you can achieve a look using this color. So thank you again for coming to my channel, and I hope to see you guys soon. And stay tuned because I'm gonna show you how to get this look. Thanks guys, bye. Don't forget to check out her channel. Bye. Okay, so what I'm gonna start with right now is this lip mask that's from Bite Cosmetics. And I got this from Sephora, so I really like this product as like a prepping kind of moisture for my lips before I put on any kind of lip product. Okay, and then we are gonna go ahead and prep our face. And two of the products that you saw there was the Too Faced Hangover RX like moisture cream. That's what I'm putting on first. And then after that, I'm going to go ahead and put on Porefessional from Benefit. And it's pretty much a prepping product for my face to eliminate from it being oily throughout the day. So I just want to cover up pretty much my T-zone area where I'm mostly oily. And now we're going to go in with Urban Decay Primer Potion for my eyes. I'm going to go ahead and put some on both of my eyes to prep it before putting on some eyeshadow and making sure that my eyeshadow stays on throughout the day. Usually when I put this on, I'll put it on with the wand, and then I like to go in with my fingers and kind of like with the warmth of my ring finger, I want to go ahead and blend that in and make sure that it stays put. And now we're going to go ahead into my eyebrows, and you guys know the routine. I usually just always use Anastasia Brow Wiz in Caramel. And now we're going to go into the eyes. First, I'm going to go ahead and prep my eyelid with some Black Bean from NYX. And I like to use this like creamy color so that when I put on the dark eyeshadow, which is going to be purple, that it will just stay that intense and dark. So now I'm just going to blend out that cream shadow and try not to go past the crease, because then you're really going to look like a raccoon. So try to keep it where your eyelid meets your crease line, and that should be enough. So my camera cut off some of this when I was already applying it, but this is from the Anastasia Lavish palette, and this is in the color Pink Sapphire. I think it's such a pretty color. It's pretty pink. But we are going to apply another color on top of that. So the purple will come out, I promise. Okay, and now what I'm doing is with that same palette, I went ahead and applied Rum Cake into my crease area to blend out those edges from Pink Sapphire. Like a ribbon, like a ribbon, like a ribbon. Okay, now what I'm doing is getting a clean blending brush and blending out all of those edges that I can see are pretty rough looking. So just clean it up and blend, 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 blend. Okay, now we are going into the Naked 3 palette from Urban Decay. And I'm going to go in with the shadow Nooner. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to put it in the crease area, but I'm going to go a little bit higher up with it. And not too far up, just high enough. And then, just keep building that up. It looks a little crappy right now, but believe me, once you start blending that out, it will look good. See, and now we just blend, blend, blend. Blend. So now I am going to go in for the brow bone area with the Self-Made palette of Anastasia, and I'm just going to go ahead and put that on my brow bone and just to highlight that area. Don't you ever say I just walked away, I will always want you. I can't let a lie running for my life, I will always want you. So now going in with Heirloom of that Anastasia Self-Made palette, I'm going to go ahead and pack that on top of that other color I already had, and I'll just do that to intensify the color and make it look more purple, which was my goal in this look. And now what you want to do is go ahead and start blending out the color. So now I'm going in with some Velour lashes, and these are in Wispy Me Away. And I currently have eyelash extensions, but I wanted to intensify the look more with these lashes. So after I've applied the lashes, I'm going in with some concealer. And this is from Cover FX, and I got this from Sephora, and this is in the color medium neutral. I really like the coverage on this for this concealer. A little bit goes a long way. So first I'm applying it with the brush, and then you guys are going to see that I'm just going to tap it in with the ring finger. That way the warmth of my finger just blends it into my skin better. And now we're going into foundation. I'm going to spray some Charge Water from MAC. And now my foundation is the Double Wear from Estee Lauder. And I'm going to go ahead and apply that with my Dampen Beauty Blender, because I feel like the Beauty Blender really gives me a good flawless finish. And now I'm going in with this Laura Mercier translucent powder to put under my under eyes and set my concealer. And now I'm going to go ahead and set my face with this Mineralize Skin Finish from MAC. And this is in the color Medium Plus. So I'm just going to go ahead and set that all over my face so that my foundation stays in place. And now I'm going to go in with the NARS Laguna Bronzer and going to use that little Kabuki brush, which is like a mini Ida brush that it has in that palette. So I'm just going to go ahead and chisel a little bit and give my cheekbone some definition. And then I'm just going to go in and blend that out a little so it doesn't look so harsh. So on my cheeks, I'm going to go ahead and apply Warm Soul from MAC. Now on my waterline, I'm going to apply this Rimmel eyeliner in the color Nude. And I'm going to smudge on the bottom of my eyelash Pink Sapphire from the Lavish palette. And on top of that, I'm going to go ahead and go with Heirloom from that other palette of Anastasia, and I'm just going to make that a little bit darker. And now I'm going in with Jaclyn Hill Champagne Pop, which is from Becca. And this is one of my all-time favorite highlighters that I like to use. And now I'm going in with Bow and Arrow from Kat Von D. And this is the star of the show, so I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. And give it a thumbs up and subscribe and make any kind of comments or suggestions you guys have for future videos. And thanks again to Stephanie Lita for doing this collab with me. I really hope you guys enjoyed both of our videos because we put a lot of work into it. So, see you guys soon. Bye.